Building SwiftUI apps, especially as a junior developer, can be very daunting, and no doubt you will make many mistakes along the way. But that's okay, because in this video I'm going to show you 6 rookie mistakes about state variables in SwiftUI. Don't make the same mistakes I did when I started out. Watch and learn. So let's learn about those 6 junior or rookie mistakes that you want to avoid with @state in SwiftUI. Before we dive into it, let me remind you about Dev Factory. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call where we can chat or talk about SwiftUI, Swift in general, or I can just take a look at your bugs or whatever you'd like me to talk about. Go ahead and check it out. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring, a 60-minute Zoom call with me. So let's start off with number one, and that is... we are going to talk about state variables and how would we be able to initialize a state variable. And the rookie mistake is that we are not putting it as a private state variable. So you would just go like @state_var is presented equals false. Now, why is this bad? Well, basically the state variable has to be initialized, right? We have it right here, set to false, in the view that is its parent, so the container view of the state. But what if we go right over here? Content view, let's just have open parentheses. Now we can see we have access to the is presented, which is not ideal. So Apple recommends this, and I highly recommend this also. I always have this set to default. Make the state variable private. So private. So private var is presented equals false. That is number one. Now, number two, having multiple sources of truth. As I told you, this is one source of truth. This is where we are initializing our so-called bucket of states where we drop in data through time. What would we do if we wanted to have a custom text to it? Let me just add in here some example for our current state variable. Well, actually, I'm going to make this as a text, and let's have it as an empty string. Let's have a text field right over here. So text field. Let's have one with the title key, maybe name, and then let's bind this to our text. So $text. I usually add in a text field style of rounded border, and also let's add a padding right over here for our VStack. Now, if we build and run, we would see our text field, but let's just add in here also a text so we can actually see our state variable. So that would be like we have a text, then a text field, and we would type in the name. Here we go. Now we can add in here Alex, and then the text is right over here. Okay, but what if I want to have this text field style, my own custom text field? So let me just create a new file, and let it be a SwiftUI view, and then let's have my text field right over there. And what I will do is just basically copy out all of this, because this is what I want to my text field, my custom text field to be. And of course, now we can see that the text is missing. So a rookie developer would say, okay, let's create a state variable for this. So let's have a private state variable of text right over here, empty string as a default value. And then I would just add in here my text field. Okay, now of course if we build and run right now and I type in Alex or anything else, the text on the content view will not be updated because, well, of course, we have two sources of truth on line 12 on the content view and also on line 12 on the my text field view. So how do we actually want to make our source of truth only one? Well, of course, we want to have this as the source of truth, so we want to bind it to our my text field, and that couldn't be easier. We just say at binding var text and of type string. So we want to make sure that this text is going to be a string. And now when we are initializing it, we actually need to add a binding. So we just go $ and text and bind that. And now we have one single source of truth. Let's see, what do we have here? Yeah, the preview provider is messing around with us, but there we go. We just type out Alex and we have a single source of truth, which is updating the text right over here. Now, number three, binding in navigation. Navigation with a sheet is quite cumbersome. And furthermore, when you want to dismiss from multiple sheets, then you might think of having a binding or a state variable as the source of truth. So let's create here kind of an example of how the navigation binding should not be used with a state variable. So let's create a new file, SwiftUI view. Let me copy this out. Let's create that. Let's create two more. So new file. Great. So now we have three destination views. How would we present our destination view one from our content view? Well, couldn't be simpler. Let's just have in here a button with an action and label. The label would say like, let's just go with a sheet. So we would just go sheet. And then we would just need a state variable for that. So let's have a private state is destination one presented. Okay, so I really like these kind of descriptive variables. So is destination view presented? We want to toggle that on the tap of our button. And of course, we want to add also a sheet with the is presented view modifier and dollar is presented. And then the content would be our destination one view. Let's just check it out if this is going to actually work. And it should. Let's just go type in one sheet, hello world. Let's slide it down. Okay. So what if we want to present the destination two view and the destination three view? And also we want to dismiss, like we want to dismiss all the way to our content view. Like dismiss all the way to the root. So let's try to figure out how that would work. So right over here, we would still need, well, let's just start off with a VStack. And we still need that button because we do want to move on to our next sheet. So we just go with a sheet. And for that, we would just need, again, a private state variable. And let's have that as false. And now we just toggle it. Is destination view presented? Let's just toggle. And on the sheet, we just go sheet is presented, dollar, and just binding it is destination to presented. And the content view is destination to view. Okay, this seems to be fair. But what if we want to dismiss? Well, then we would just have to kind of bind it. Of course, we can use the dismiss environment, but not in this case. I want to make sure that we are doing this with the state variables. So what we want to do is bind the content views is destination one view, one presented to our destination view one view. So let's have a binding right over here at binding var, and that is destination one presented, and that's of type bool. Okay, and if we want to dismiss, actually we want to have it as a toggle, so button, and again an action and label, and let's have this as maybe pop, and is a destination one presented dot toggle. Okay, we have written some quite of code. Let's build and run and see what we got here. Oh, of course, we want to have this removed, and then we want to add our binding. So view is destination one we presented, and that is dollar is destination one presented. Okay, so we build and run. Let's present our sheet. We can pop, that's great. And then we can present our next sheet. Okay, let's move forward because now we are getting to our destination two view. And actually I want to copy out some stuff from here. Basically, I want to have those two buttons also. So let me just have them right over here. But now I want to have, of course, a binding and a state variable. So let's just do this. Right over here, And that would be binded to destination one, of course, because I want to pop back to root. And then this would be is destination three presented. When we tap on that button, destination is presented is going to be toggled. And then right over here, we want to have the destination three view and the is presented binding right over here. Okay, so this would be pop to root actually, because we are popping is destination one presented. So let's see how this is going to behave. And now we are going to get into a little bit of trouble. Well, actually, let's just remove the preview provider again. Let's build and run. And yes, we do need to have is destination one view presented. So dollar is destination one presented. Moved on to our destination two view. Okay, sheet, another sheet, and then of course the sheet. And if we just go down and pop to root, well, actually, it's not going to pop to root. It's just going to pop only one. And if I tap on pop here, nothing will be going on. We will have this alert, which will say that, okay, this is already being presented. So it's kind of a mess. And the problem here is that the destination two is already presented. So here's what we need to do right over here. First of all, we don't want to toggle the is presented, but we want to also bind the is destination to view presented. So let's just do that. Let me just copy that out, paste it in there. There we go. And now we need to have two bindings. So is destination two presented, and I'm binding it to the state variable. So is destination two presented. Okay, that's fine. Now right over here, I'm going to dismiss, like toggle the two destination two presented, and also I'm going to wait a little bit, because otherwise it would just basically not work. We need to have that animation first. So we are going to use dispatch queue dot main dot async after the deadline, and we are just going to go now, and plus 0.6 seconds. That's what kind of roughly the animation is. And then I want to go is, I believe we need to have self here because we are inside the completion. So is destination one presented dot toggle. So this is what we'll do. We are going to dismiss the destination two, and then we are going to toggle the is destination one. So let's just do that again. Popping works okay. Now let's go to the sheet. Now pop to root, and as you can see, it's going to be as okay. So yeah, you can just figure out how you would just do this with destination free view, but basically that's the gist of it. You don't want to actually move only the destination one presented, but you also want to move the destination two presented and toggle them in a timely manner. So first of all, the two presented and then one presented. And yes, this is really, really complicated. Go ahead and check out. I'm going to create a new video on how to use navigation, a stack and navigation in iOS 16 more efficiently. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel and make sure that you hit the notification bell to get notified when that video is going to come out. Okay, number four, not listening to changes or confusing changes with new value. So let me just go back to our content view right over here. And what is actually listening to changes? Because many people don't really know that. You can actually listen to these changes of the state variable, and that is the on change of view modifier. Now here we need to add, let's just go with the is destination one presented, and what I'm going to do is just simply print out the new value. Basically we have our new value. Let's build and run. It has succeeded. Okay, sheet, now it's true. If we pop back, now it's false. Okay, that's really great. But what if we have, now this is an interesting one, what if we have the same value toggled? So let's just go under the destination view, and yeah, what I'm going to do here is a little bit of what we actually don't really want, but let me just set this not to toggle, but set this to true. So we are going to set this to true again. So let's just build and run, taking the sheet, popping back, As you can see, nothing really happens because, and it's not printed out because the state of that value is not being changed. So it's still true. So we are not receiving a new value. We're not listening to receiving a new value. We're listening to the on change of a new value. So yeah, basically that's it. Let me just move this back to toggle. Number five, not using enums as values. Now you see right over here, we have values and these are true or false, like state variables as a string or an int value or a Boolean value. But you are most probably better off if you are using enums. And the simplest way of doing this is, let's say, an authentication. So right over here, let's say we would just have, I'm not going to create the views themselves, I'm just going to be a text, but what if we have an authentication situation? So with the authentication situation, you want to wait a little bit till the actual server comes back with, okay, we are authenticated or we are not authenticated. So there is not defined. So we are going to have an enum right over here. Okay, let's have those cases, undefined, authenticated, and authenticated. Okay, so we have these three states because a true and false is not really great for this. So how would that look like? Let me just comment these out. So let's have here an authenticated state. So we just have a private state and auth state, and this would be of type authenticated state. I just copy and paste that. The default value would be undefined. Now, how would we use this inside our view? Well, we would just go through all of these switch statements for our auth state. And as you can see, Xcode 14 is really nice and it's helping us with the switch case. Undefined, we're just going to have a progress view for the undefined, maybe just, yeah, just spinning around, authenticated. I just have a text of authenticated. And let's have a text under not authenticated of login, please. Okay, so this is how we would just do these state variables. And of course, when we are changing the state, let's say we had some response from the servers, we are just going to set the auth state to the specific authenticated state. It's much more flexible and much more, of course, user-friendlier than just a Boolean value of is it authenticated, true or false? Because we do need our undefined state also. Okay, number six, using a published instead of a state. Now, this is really, really important because as of SwiftUI 4, we have some issues with this. We have that purple warning with the navigation. And if you do want to learn more about that one, go ahead and check it out. The video is right over here.